This video will show you the basics of working with layers inside CorelDRAW. We will create a 3-page business card document and design multiple cards while using the features of the Object Manager. Some of the topics covered are adding and renaming layers, adding a master layer, understanding the features of the Object Manager, and 3 tips of when to use the Object Manager that you may not think of. If you are watching this video on YouTube, you can pause the video and click on the link in the description below to go to the tutorial page so that you can download the base business card file and a written copy of the tutorial to follow along. Let's get started by creating a new business card size document. Come up here to File, choose New. Over in the size, let's choose Business Card and click OK. Now I'm going to import some artwork I already have and add it to our card by going to File, Import, and browsing to where I need it, clicking it, and click Import. And if I hit the space bar, it'll land right on my page and we can get started with our modifications. First, let's open the Object Manager. To open the Object Manager, go to Window, Dockers, Object Manager. Now let's add 2 blank pages to this document. You can add blank pages by clicking on this plus sign down next to the page and adding a page, or you can right click on the page and click Insert Page After. Another way also is to go up to the layout menu and click Insert Page. So let's click back on our first page and let's get going. Okay, now we're going to create some layers and rename them. The first thing we need to do is select our art and ungroup it. So select your art and come up to the toolbar and select Ungroup. Now come over to the Object Manager and come down to the New Layer button and click it. And this first layer we're going to make is going to be called Name. And let's make another one and we'll call that one Phone. Now what we can do is they're empty because you see no plus or minus sign over here in the layer, so we can drag objects to those layers. So let's select our name and drag it to the Name layer. And now you see the minus sign showed up here. Now let's click our phone number and drag it to the phone layer, and it's added to the phone layer. With these layers, you can drag them around up and above and below and in any order you need to make them visible or on top or below each other. Since we need to make business cards for 3 different employees, using a master layer for the company information will work great. The master layer contains objects you want to appear on all pages in your document. Thus, in our business card, we want the company information on all 3 of them. So let's add a master layer. Come on over here to the Object Manager and go to the icon next to the New Layer icon and click the New Master Layer icon. And we'll add one there and let's name it Company. All right, it's blank right now, but let's click on my company information, which is already grouped, and let's drag it to the company master layer on the master page right here. So now, if we go to look at page 2 and 3 that were previously blank, they will now have the master layer information. They won't have the name and phone number that's on the first page, but they have the company information. Now let's customize our other 2 cards. So for those cards, we need the name and the phone number on those pages as well. So let's copy the layers from page 1 onto pages 2 and 3. Let me show you how to do that via the Object Manager. So anytime you see red on a layer, that means that's the current active layer. Let's click on the name though, and name layer on page 1, right click, choose copy, come down to page 2, and click there, right click, and paste. And repeat the same process on page 3. Let's click on that layer and paste. So it adds the name of those are both now on page 2 and 3. Let's do the same thing with the phone number. So let's click the phone layer, right click, copy, come down here, right click, paste, come down here, right click, and paste. So now we have a copy of each of those layers on the other 2 pages. We can rename them if we want to match the first page. So we can right click and choose rename. And we can call that one phone. And we can click on this one and rename it as well. You can if you want to, but you don't have to. So we'll do those. Let's rename these ones as well. Phone. And if you click a second time, it lets you type right in there. And there we go. Now we have three matching layers on each of the three pages. And we have extra layer there, but we'll do a little cleanup later. Now we all need to do is edit the text on each of those layers to make pure custom cards for each person on each page. Now let's do the edits to the custom cards on page 2 and 3. So on page 2, let's click on the name. And that's activating the name layer. And let's click on the name on the page. And let's go up here to the edit text button. And let's change this to Lisa Miles. Click OK. And then if we want to edit the phone, let's make that layer active. Click on the phone number. Let's edit it. And let's change that to ending in number 2. Let's repeat the same process for page 3 to get those customized. So click on the phone number or the name, doesn't matter what order you do them in. And you can also, if you want them in exact order to match the top, you can reorder them by dragging them. So we click on the name, click on the name here. We can edit it. Let's change this one to Ann Parks. And click OK. And this one, select the phone layer. And let's edit it. And we can select that phone number. So if you don't want to click here, you can also, I'll click off so you can see, if we open that layer and you select on it here in the layers panel, it'll select it as well. Let's change that to a 3. And now all our layers are customized. Now we can review all three cards to make sure they look the way we want. So let's look at page 1, which is our original card, ending in 1 for his extension. And let's click page 2. Lisa Miles ends with 2 with her extension. And page 3, Ann Parks, and her extension ends in a 3. Our card is good to go. Now that our cards are complete and ready to print, I just want to show you some features of the Object Manager. If you need to hide a layer, you can turn the hide a layer by turning it off with this eyeball. That will make it invisible, and you see the minus sign. If you want to turn it back on, click it again, it will reappear. If you want to expand a layer or a group, click on the plus sign next to the layer, and it will show you the items inside that layer. You can select items here to select them on the page as well. If you need to lock a layer, click on the lock inside next to the layer. This will make it so you can't move it, can't click on it or anything. Unlock, click it again. A good time to use the lock layer is if you're going to manually trace an image that you bring in. You can lock the bitmap so that you can manually trace over it and not accidentally move it as you're drawing it. A good example in this project, we could have locked the master layer so that nothing would get moved. You may want to import an object or groups of objects into your design to help with positioning of other elements. In this case, you may not want it to print. So in order to do that, just click your print icon and it will disable the printing for that layer. But keep in mind, when you disable the printing, you also disable the exporting. So if you need that turned on, turn it back on to export it. Sometimes it helps to see the object properties inside the Object Manager. Let me show you how to do that. Go to the top of the Object Manager and click on the Show Object Properties button. It looks like nothing happened, but let's expand our Docker so we can see what's going on. So now, in order to see some details, just expand the objects on the company layer in the master layer. And now if we expand some more, we can see all the colors and fonts exactly how it's created. And if you can also click on things without ungrouping them nicely in here as well. That's another trick with using the Object Manager. Another thing is you can drag layers between pages. So if we needed a copy of a different phone number or a different art that's on page 1 and you need it on page 2, and or you just don't want it on page 1 anymore, drag it down, it's on page 2. And earlier I said we were going to do some cleanup and we can delete layers. So we realize our layer 1s are all empty on our pages because we don't need those anymore. Select the layer, delete, select the layer. Delete, and there's no plus here, that means there's nothing on the layer, and delete that one as well. And let's close up our Object Manager, and our file is nice and clean and organized. Also know, another way to delete a layer is to right click on it and delete it. Another nice thing dealing with layers is that each page can have its own guides layer. So natively, the program creates them on the master layer. You show this guidelines here, but if you want it on page 2 guides, you can drag that to the guides layer on page 2. And we're on page 2 so we can see it, but right now if we go to page 3, that guide is not on page 3. If you do a lot of work in wireframe, you can associate a color with each layer. So let's click on this black box next to the name, and we'll bring up the color dialog box and select a color and click OK. And let's double click on the box next to the phone and let's select another color. And it looks like nothing happened, but if you go into view and wireframe, now each of those colors we labeled are now assigned with each of the pieces on those layers. So if you have a complicated design where you're trying to discern different objects from each other, this works great. Now it's time for my 3 tips about layers in CorelDRAW. If you create art with layers in CorelDRAW and you need that art in PhotoPaint, just export the CorelDRAW file as a .cpt PhotoPaint file and then choose Maintain Layers in the export options, and those layers will appear in PhotoPaint just like you created them in CorelDRAW. Tip number 2 is when you need page numbers on pages, use the page number function in CorelDRAW with a combination of a master layer to number pages in a brochure. Let me show you how to do that. So if we go to File, New, we'll just create a blank 8.5 by 11 page. And we're also gonna create a new master layer in our document. And we'll just call that page number. And now if we go to Layout and Insert Page Number, an active layer, because the active layer is red, it's going to add a page number. I'm just going to make it big so you can see it. And now if we add extra pages to our document, now they're automatically updated for you just by using a master layer inside the Object Manager. My third tip is to use the Object Manager when you're having trouble finding or clicking on an object. When inside the Object Manager, you see the objects as a list, like a spreadsheet with all the objects' properties of their colors and fonts right in front of you. In order to see those properties, all you have to do is make sure you click on the pluses to expand each of these groups or layers, and you can see all the details listed right in front of you. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of this tutorial and the business card exercise file to follow along, and find other helpful tutorials for CorelDRAW.